Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
You know what they say about reckoning?
I don't, but I reckon it's a lot like assuming.
Yeah, something like that.
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
I got much choice?
Sure don't. Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman. Driving this man once, he was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting.
All officers are available for incoming U-1.
And before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop. But that's government property. And I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
Maybe he was innocent.
Innocent? They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. Oh, I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so. This other time...
Gun out.
Hey! Hey, officer! Are you all right? I'm still cuffed back here! I need to drag myself out that window. Oh.
It'll be easier to carry with these cuffs off. Officer? God damn. Holy shit! What in the hell? Get away from me! Yeah.